Chris, are you gonna get highlights?
Yeah.
Are we gonna do extensions?
And get some blonde streaks, put some more whites in there.
What if you did like the original Fernando Vargas haircut? Everything shaved except the little strand in the front. Everybody used to do that.
That's Henry's haircut. I remember that.
You know, I was a kid.
Just the bangs.
In the other side of the world, people were doing that. In
really?
Israel, yep.
Holy shit.
Yeah, Fernando had a big reach. Him and Canelo would have been a big fight.
Oh man, imagine.
You know, Canelo right now might fight Jaime Munguia or Triple G or Kovalev. What do you think of those three fights?
You wouldn't either one of them.
He beats them all?
Dude, right now, I think right now, he even beats Mayweather right now. That's why, like, if Mayweather would have waited this long, Mayweather would have lost to Canelo.
But
Mayweather's just smart. He just took him at the right time.
But when I just asked you about Pacquiao, Mayweather, you say Mayweather beats Pacquiao again.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
You think he just figured him out? Or?
He has it. But the thing is that Canelo's still a baby when he fought him, man.
22.
Yeah, he's still a baby. He hasn't learned anything. He wasn't learning anything. He's learned so much. He's developed so much since that fight.
He fights like Floyd a little bit now. He reminds me of Floyd, some of the moves. What happened?
Boy?
What happened?
Whatchamacallit,
he did improve a lot since that fight.
Yeah, a lot. And
what's your tablet?
Your tablet's right there. And, you know, Pacquiao. Pacquiao's the same Pacquiao he was before. Maybe a little older, but he's the same Pacquiao. But as far as Canelo, he's changed a lot.
He won SP Boxer of the Year. Not that it means anything, because nobody cares.
Boy, go bring me my wallet and my keys then. Thank you.
Nobody really cares, but it's still a nice honor, because he doesn't fight on ESPN. I thought they'll give it to ESPN fighter.
Yeah.
So let me ask you this. Who's the best 147 right now? Is it Spence, Crawford, Pacquiao?
Or Spence's, hands down. Hands down, he's the best 147 pounder. Man, the thing about him, he's like naturally like a 154, but he's fine at 147.
He walks around at 175.
He's a strong 147. And he's, like I said, he spars with the Charlo brothers, you know? And when he spars with someone like that, then you go in the ring with someone at 147 with not the skill that the Charlo brothers have, it just makes it that much easier for him.
It's true. By the way, so you have a big fight coming up, August 3rd, right?
Mm-hmm.
Adam Karnowski, similar style, both of you guys. He likes to bang. He doesn't look like he's in shape, but he's a boxer. He's in shape like yourself, like Andy Ruiz. Like, you can't. But he's talented. He's a Polish guy.
Yeah.
What does Chris Arreola have to do on fight night? You obviously know him.
I have to make sure he doesn't hit me as much. I have to make sure that I counter when I have to count. But the thing is, I just got to bring excitement. That's the main thing.
Put on a good show.
Put on a great
If you
show.
Win, the show continues. If you don't win, you said you're retiring.
But in the end, I gotta make sure I put on a good show, even if I do retire.
That's true. Mm-hmm. Now, we've seen two Adam Karnowski. We've seen him go the distance with Charles Martin, and we've seen him smoke, when he fought, I think, Gerald Washington, two rounds. So, you're expecting both.
I don't give a fuck. He doesn't know who's gonna expect out of me, so we're gonna see on Saturday, who got the big guns that day.
That's true. You go ahead.
You know, just fade me out, just the side. Don't touch the top. I'm good at the top.
Okay. Just a regular fade, like a fade or a fade?
Yeah. No, just like a fade.
Fade, mid, low?
Medium.
Did your dad still have hair?
Huh?
Everybody in your family still has hair?
Yeah, my dad, my grandfather passed away with a full set of hair.
It's like Mars and Mikey.
Off the top, right?
Yeah.
The big G still has that full hair.
Yeah, it's crazy. Like, all they had was just a bunch of grandma. My grandfather fucking dyed his hair to the day he died. But he had a full set of hair.
Was he a fan? Was he a boxing fan?
Nah.
He didn't?
Nah. He was an alcohol fan.
Was your dad... Your dad's a boxing fan. I see him at the fight.
Yeah.
He's the one who got you into it?
Yeah.
Why? Why not take you to a baseball field, a basketball court?
I didn't like baseball. Because I grew up in boxing, man. My dad used to be a boxer. And I used to bark him, make me go straight to the gym.
Was he good?
Nah. That's all right.
You have a sparring?
Growing up, I always wanted to spar him. And by the time I got, like, his weight...
He was...
He had already lost his arm. He only had one arm and shit, so I couldn't fuck him up. But that was my goal, was to get in the ring and beat his ass.
How did he lose an arm? Accident?
In a job accident, man. Oh, shit. He was cleaning a machine, and it just fucking demolished his arm.
That's terrible.
Yeah.
I mean, they couldn't detach it or nothing.
It's still there. Like, it's attached, but it's just there.
He can't use it, yeah.
He can't use it, can't do nothing.
That's sad.
Yeah. It's all right.
It's life.
Yeah, it's life.
And then, obviously this fight, but you take care of business. Any idea what comes next, or just August 3rd? That's the...
See, the main thing right now is August 3rd. That's the main thing. But after that, man, I'm just trying to stay busy. I win this fight, and then I get back into it and get another fight before the year's over. That's the man. I want to get another fight before the year's over after I win this fight.
And now the heavyweight division is popping. It's very interesting. Andy Ruiz mixed it up. You have Wilder. You have... You and Fury, you'll fight?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I think it'll be a fun fight.
Because you talk trash, he talks trash. I think you're a better boxer than he is. He moves a lot. But once you figure out his rhythm, that's it.
See, and the thing about it, I don't even talk that much trash anymore. I just sit back and just relax and laugh about it. I like it. I enjoy the shit talking.
It makes it fun.
Exactly. It makes training more, a lot more fun. It gives meaning to the training.
It's like when Thurman talked trash to Manny, Manny landed in the Philippines after the first camp, straight to the gym. It just got him excited.
Really?
Yeah. He trained for this camp like none other just because of the trash talk. Some guys use it as fuel.
Who's training them right now?
You have Boo Boy, Justin Fortune, and Freddie.
Oh, okay. That's good then.
And I think Boo Boy's the main trainer. Justin does strength and conditioning, and Freddie's like...
like the talk, like the voice.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's good though. That's super good. Because, Freddie knows him like no one else does. And Fortune's been with him way back
when. Yeah, 06.
Yeah, way back when.
Or 02, something like that. Yeah,
yeah, before he went to Ariza, right?
Correct.
And, he'd be a good camp.
Well, it's 1 week away from tonight. Hopefully you'll be there.
I'll be there Saturday.
To promote, okay.
Yeah, just for the fight, but I won't be out here training all week. Gotta work, man.
People don't see the hard workers. All they see is the ring walk and in the ring. They have no idea what you did a week before, or Tuesday, a month before, how much you sacrificed, how much you ran, how much the sit-ups.
This is sparring. This is when the fight. Fight night is just showcase. That's all you do, is just showcase and just show off. This
guy right here. It's like Muhammad Ali, what do you say? Suffer now and live the rest of your life like a champ.
He's a real boxer. That's what he meant to do.
But what, did the fans recognize you in this part of Los Angeles?
Nah,
more
not so
Riverside,
much.
You're the mayor. Everywhere you go in Riverside, everyone knows you. I walk into a bar, they go, Chris Arreola comes here.
Nah, not really, man. I honestly just real low key, and I guess because I just walk like a regular dude and people just don't notice me that much. You know, I don't hold myself like with my nose up high and
you're not a douche.
Like thinking I'm like, yeah, I have to strut my chest out and show everybody whose dick is bigger. I'm alright with just hanging in the background, just watching a movie, paying for my tickets and stuff like that. You know what I mean?
No.
So that's why I think I'm not really out there. Cause I'm just really just me. I'm just chill. Like when I go to Dodger games, yeah, people recognize me, but I'm just keep it going. Just keep it walking, man.
Are the Dodgers any good this year?
Fuck yeah, they are. The first
they always, in the West. And then what happens in the playoffs?
Hey, come on, bro.
I'm just asking.
Alright, we've been doing. We get to the World Series the past 2 years.
Maybe this year.
Last year I wasn't as mad losing to the Boston Red Sox, but the year before. When we lost to Texas to Astros.
Yeah, but that was because you have to understand how America works.
I'm sorry? There
was I'll explain to you how it works in the business world.
Okay.
There was a tragedy in Houston, and America likes a good story.
Yeah.
They like, you know what I mean? Like, it lifts it. So many times business and sports mix, the business will win because it's a better story.
Kind of like when New Orleans won the Super Bowl.
Yep, exactly.
The whole Katrina thing.
Yeah. And you can see it sometimes, you know, it's...
That's crazy though, if it really does play down like that, play off like that.
I think, well, here's my question. The umpires, who pays their salary? Is it Major League Baseball? So they could kind of guide them to, maybe not tell them bluntly, like, who should win, but say it's better for the fans, like, give them a hint.
Yeah.
I don't know if it works like that, like I'm saying.
Hope not. Yeah. I really do. I hope it doesn't work like that.
I think the...
I guess LA needs a bigger earthquake then. So we and then, you know, feel good story.
Yeah. That's how it works. And that's business, I think, is always wins in sports.
Yeah.
The bigger money, A side. Like, if you have a fight with two guys and the A side does worse, but he brings in more money, he'll always win. Always get the decision. We see it. And then the fans get mad, but a week later they forget and they say, oh, we're here, you know, they let us slide.
See, now, another thing about, like, Canelo versus Munguia, man, that's. Munguia's too young. He's still a puppy.
But it's a good opportunity for a payday and a chance to fight for a title. But he may not be ready.
He has a small title though, right?
54. But he would move up to 60 for this.
Yeah.
And he didn't look that good his last fight.
Yeah.
So. But then again, the question is, Canelo has 8 fights left on his $365 million deal. Who does he fight? He has to fight. I mean, Kovalev?
Kovalev is a better one. I think Kovalev is a pretty good fight for him.
Triple G3?
Triple G3 is always a great one. But I think he wins the Triple G3 a lot better, a lot easier. I wasn't that impressed with Triple G with...
his last guy?
With his new trainer?
Jonathan Banks. But it was only their first fight, so...
Yeah, it was his first fight, but I wasn't that impressed. But we'll see.
Yeah. By the way, how's sparring been?
Ah, tough, man.
Why?
Loving it.
Are you working on new things, or the sparring partners just want to prove themselves because we're sparring Chris Arreola, so...
A little bit of the both.
Yeah.
And they're like, I don't get no time off, you know what I mean? Like, they just want to go, and I'm just, all right, hold on.
You're not used to that.
Yeah. But, and then also, with Joe, we spar 3-4 days a week.
You're not used to that at all. Nobody does that. Usually Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
Yeah, or just 2 days. I was actually, at one point, I was already